This jump demonstration shows how to perform process capability analysis for multiple responses. We're using the semiconductor capability data from the sample data library. This dataset contains 128 measures from a semiconductor manufacturing process. Note that each of the columns for these measures has its spec limits column property set. For example, here are the spec limits for NPN1. We'll delete these for the purpose of demonstrating what happens with columns that don't yet have their spec limits set before we start the analysis. We'll begin our capability analyses by going to Analyze, Quality and Process, and choosing Process Capability. We'll place our process variables into the Y process role. Let's use just a subset of our full 128 variables for now. Note that we have additional options below the Y process button. For example, for specifying subgroup sizes and for handling non-normal distributions. When we're ready, we'll click OK. Because one or more of our columns didn't have their spec limits set, we're presented with a dialog to specify the spec limits. We'll enter those manually now, but note that at the top of the dialog, we also have the option to import spec limits from a separate data table. This can be a helpful time saver. In the report, the goal plot plots each process's spec standardized mean by its spec standardized standard deviation. Put another way, it's a plot of how on or off target a process is against how variable that process is relative to its spec limits. Any process inside the red triangle has a PPK of 1 or greater, but this PPK cutoff can be adjusted using the slider on the right. For any process of interest, we can hover over the point to see a control chart graphlet, and we can click on the graphlet to view that process in the control chart builder platform. Under the red triangle for the goal plot, we can choose shade levels to help us more easily distinguish problematic processes. Below the goal plot, the capability box plots show spec standardized distributions of each process variable. And below that, the capability index plot shows the PPK value of each process, with a red line at a PPK cutoff of 1. As with the goal plot, the PPK cutoff value can be changed using the slider on the right. And, as with the goal plot, we have the option to shade levels under the red triangle. Many other options are available under the top red triangle. For example, the process performance plot helps assess process stability and capability simultaneously. And the individual detail reports allow us to dive into the capability of each process in greater detail.